Hey there, welcome to the Healthy Vibes Podcast. I am Kelly Renato, your host, a mom of two, and a fitness and health enthusiast and encourager. I'm on a mission to help moms feel good about themselves, find time for themselves, and get their strength back so that every single day they can show up how they want to. I know what it's like to feel overwhelmed, unhealthy as a mom, anxious, worn out, and never enough. That is why I want to share with you every single week, simple choices that have helped me to feel more confident and content. Each week, I'll bring you a short dose of inspiration for you and your family, empowering you to show up for yourself, love who you are, and encouraging you to become more intentional every day with your choices so that you can feel stronger, more confident, and fulfilled. Are you ready to truly love who you are? Get out of that rat race, know that you're enough, and follow the path that you want to? It's time to nurture your mind, body, and soul. You get to make this choice every single day, and I want to help you. Let's start today. You ready? Here we go. Hey there, welcome to the Healthy Vibes Podcast. I'm Kelly Renato, and thank you for being with me today. I'm so happy that you are here. If you are new to the podcast, welcome. And if you are back again, thank you for coming back. That means the world to me. And if you are enjoying these podcasts, please, please share them with a friend. And I would love, love for you to leave a review and let me know what you think. That would mean the world to me. So today, episode 43, we are going to talk about how we should all start not only working out our bodies, but we should work out our minds. And this is kind of goes along with everything I've been talking about for the last few weeks, but which it's the timing of my journal goes along with it as well, because that's exactly what it is. Not only does it help us keep accountable for working out ourselves, but working out our mind. And I want you to think of it this way, because I know when I started working out my mind years ago, I think at first I would do this or that, and you know, I would start doing certain things, affirmations, gratitude practice, waking up earlier, and honestly, it would feel good, it would help me, but I would fall right back into my bumpy road, and then I would be like, geez, I'd get back on track. And I was listening to Mel Robbins' Mindset Reset at the time. It was 30 days, and every day was something different, a different tip, a different for your mind. It was great, because what I learned over that course is that just like working out your body, just like saving money, just like anything we do, you don't just do it for a few days and everything's good. And I always like to tell the story, and I've had a few people, clients along the way. And I had one client at one point that I remember I would stretch him every day, and he would come in and we'd stretch and we'd come in and we'd stretch, and he did it for a few weeks. And then all of a sudden one day he goes, you know what? I feel great. He goes, I think I'm good now. I won't be back for a while. And I looked at him, I said, well, you have to keep stretching. And he goes, but no, I'm good. I'm great now. Like, he thought we had got to the point that we needed to be and all was great now. And I said, no, I said, this is a lifestyle. This is something you have to keep doing. And I think with all of us, in a sense, if you don't change your mindset and your perspective that whatever you're doing to better yourself is a new daily practice, it is something new that you're going to do every day, it's your lifestyle, it's a whole change, then yes, you will stay on the roller coaster or the yo-yo diets, or you are going to nonstop go up and down in all of it. It has to be an everyday thing. So I want you to look at your mind as the same way. Don't just start working on daily affirmations and saying something positive to yourself today, tomorrow, and the next day, and then stop. It's an everyday thing. And that's why with my journal, I wanted to make it, because I wanted to make it so that I wouldn't have to get up and print my daily motivation plan. I wouldn't have to get up and remember. I would have a journal every day to prompt me what to do. And I will say, so every single day you have to do the work, and you'll notice if you fall off track. So just like going to the gym or working out or walking every day. And I'm the same with that too, walking every day. If I don't do it, if I don't go out and exercise, I don't feel good. But I've gotten to the point in my life where I'm really good at that. It takes time, but I got there. So then the mind was when I realized I had to do it every single day. Excuse me. I had to stay on track. That was when my life changed. So every day I would do gratitude practice. Every day I had affirmations I would say to myself in my head. And honestly, a big one for your mind is what affects your energy. So not only doing good things for our mind, but knowing what we need to stop doing for our mind, they're just as important as each other. So there were things that I would notice, even though I was doing gratitude practice, I was doing affirmations, I was putting on good music, I was saying my prayers, I was doing my devotions, I was exercising, I was, reading my Bible, whatever it was, I was doing all of those things every day. I had to start paying attention to what I needed to stop doing, what I needed to say no to. And this is huge. This is something I've talked about before, talking about your energy. I want you to know, and I want you to become aware of what's affecting it, because that affects your mind. So if there's people in your life that you see every single day, that maybe they say something negative to you, maybe they question what you're doing. I can't believe you're doing that. Or I can't believe you're going there. I can't believe you still do that. Why are you doing that? They don't, maybe they don't mean anything big. Maybe you don't even realize it's affecting you, but I want you to start paying attention. Awareness is the key to everything. Once you become aware, you will be surprised how much your life changes, because if you can adjust coming in contact with things, and some things we can't, let's be honest, there's some people in your office, some people, that you're just going to have to see where you work every day. But if you become aware, you still can change how you respond. You could change maybe your path. If you're nonstop walking past their desk to go to the break room, maybe you need a different path. If every time you walk past, they say something, or they stop and they complain, or they're gossiping, or they have something negative to say about the job, pay attention to this, because these things are affecting your mind. And you'd be surprised, you go back to your office and it's replaying in your mind and you don't even realize it. And that's what I was finding. I had things replaying on my mind over and over, and I had to stop them. But it was a combination of things that stopped it. So if it was someone I was seeing that was always dragging me down or draining me or not lifting me up, and if I didn't have to see them, if it wasn't like a family member, I would make sure I stopped seeing them. Or you change how often you talk to them if it's someone you have to talk to. But all of these things affect your mind. Maybe it's yourself. Maybe it's something that you say every morning and you don't even realize you do. So maybe you walk out and you're like, oh, I gotta, take the dog out again. However you're saying things, think about it. I promise if you switch how you're saying things and you become aware of how you're saying it, it will change things. So this week, I want you, your takeaway is your mind is everyday work. What you choose matters. What you choose to do every day, so gratitude practice, devotion, healthy choices, exercise, praying, all of the good things, saying affirmations, maybe you pick three that you say every morning, all of these healthy, good, positive things, you got to do them every day. You got to pick some of them. You got to do them every day. Because I promise you, what you fill your mind with matters. And this takes time, but over time, you will be surprised. Like, my mind has shifted so much. I used to have so many negative thoughts, and I really don't have as many anymore. And I catch them. If they come and I start to say something negative, I change it. And in the beginning, this was really, really hard, but it's gotten so much better. So not only is the work on your mind what you're going to do, but it's also going to be noticing to keep things out that are negative, keep things that are affecting your energy. And this can be, so listen, even people you love, it's the way if they say something, how you respond matters. I want you to remember that you can control how you respond. So even if, because think about it, we get into habits of not even realizing how we're saying things. We really do. All of us do. So even if it's someone you love, someone you live with, someone you see all the time, so if they are nonstop being negative, complaining, just nicely say, hey, let's try to, listen, turn that around. Like, just say it nicely to them. Hey, say that in a different way. If you say it this way, I promise you, you're going to see it differently. Like, you try to help them too. And just say, listen, this week, I'm working on my mind. So we're all in this house, and this is what I did in the beginning too. I would say, we're all going to be positive this week. I want us all to think about what comes out of our head. Because the more positive, the better we're all going to feel. But it's human nature to sometimes complain. And you'll notice with people you surround yourself with. Like, I had to get away from mom groups because there was so much gossip and complaining. I couldn't do it anymore. And listen, this is not to put myself on a pedestal and say I'm better, because I wasn't. I was doing the same thing. But that's how I had to get away from it, because I wanted to stop. It wasn't making me feel good. You know, and I was homeschooling my kids at the time, but I would notice when I'd get around other moms, no matter where we were, the baseball field or anywhere, they would all be complaining about school. And I wasn't even in public school, but I had to like step away, because it was just so much complaining. And not that we shouldn't be able to vent. Listen, I vent still, and I have people that I call, even, that I know will make me feel better. And even I have to say, my brother left me a message the other day that said, you know, he was calling me because he knew that I would make him feel better. And listen, I'm not always in a good place. I do my best to try and, you know, help each other. But same with him. My brothers usually lift me up if I call them. So you have those people that you go to. Like, I have certain friends I know if I talk to or open up to, they're like so close to God, and they will help me by bringing me closer to God, or giving me a verse, or sending me a devotion, or sending me something they read. And I love it. Like, it makes my heart, it warms my heart to know that I found people in my life that will help me with what I'm going through by bringing me closer to God, or lifting me up, or encouraging me. Because we all go through that. So I'm not saying that you shouldn't vent, or sometimes we're going to complain. I'm saying the day-to-day, nonstop complaining about things we don't need to complain about is what I'm saying. You know, whatever. If you're always, oh, I got to take the kids to school. Oh, it's my day for carpool. Oh, geez, I got to. If you're complaining about the daily activities that you could find joy in and you could not complain, you will change your life. I promise you will. Because I was that person. I was quick to complain about the things I didn't need to complain about. And when you switch it, oh my gosh, you realize like these years are fleeting. They're going to go by so fast. And I don't want to look back and think I complained about it. So the best project you will ever work on is you. And I read that somewhere before. It doesn't mean that we are a mess, which, you know, I say I am a lot, but we are worth the work. We're all wonderful just how we are. But you can enjoy your life so much more and feel so much better about yourself and just feel good every day if every single day you choose to do something to improve yourself, to grow, fill yourself up with good. I promise you, it matters. So this week, choose to do the work on your mind. And you choose one thing you're going to work on this week. Gratitude practice every morning. Going on a walk every day. Saying 3 affirmations every morning. Wake up and look in the mirror and say, I love who you are. You are a strong person. You are brave. You are courageous. Say, you know, positive things. Or choose to become more aware of what is not making you feel good this week and learn what you can do about it. Can you avoid it? Can you say something? Can you try to make it more positive? So figure it out. If you need help with this, please reach out to me. Email me, message me. You can find me at my website. You can find me on Instagram. So reach out to me and please send this to a friend if you think they need to hear it. Please, please, please. share it. That's the way more moms will get these simple messages, because that's all I want. My goal is to help as many moms as I can feel better about themselves, enjoy their days more, and just feel more calm and more in control of their days. So thanks for being here. Have a great, great week. And one of my favorite verses that I have to leave you with today is Romans 12:2. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So enjoy your week. Take care. Thanks for being here. Bye-bye.
I appreciate you sharing this time with me today. I am grateful you are here. And if you have anyone that you feel could also benefit from this encouragement, please share it with them today. You can also add a quick review on iTunes, which would mean the world to me and help me just to make this better for each and every one of you out there. I will be here each week, so please be sure to subscribe to the podcast or join me at kellyrenato.com to get the latest episode and more tools to help you on your journey to feel your best and enjoy every single day exactly where you are. I would love to have you join my journey, and let's all add good, healthy vibes anywhere we can, every single day. Enjoy your week and embrace the season you're in, and I look forward to next week. Take care. Bye-bye.